Hi, I am Eleftheria and I'm a massage instructor. When I first started working as a massage therapist, I weighed around 50 kilos. One of my biggest challenges was working with much larger clients, people with dense musculature or simply more body mass. I quickly realized that relying on brute strength was not only ineffective, but also unsustainable. That's what led me to start thinking more seriously about biomechanics, how to use leverage, gravity, and positioning to work smarter, not harder. Which is why I decided to record this episode. Hey, welcome back to the science behind massage. Today, we're shifting our focus from the internal physiological responses to the external physical forces at play during a massage session. We're going to explore the biomechanics of massage, understanding how force, leverage, and body mechanics can optimize your technique and prevent injury. This is crucial for both the therapist's longevity and the client's experience. Let's start with the basics. In physics, force is any interaction that, when unopposed, will change the motion of an object. In massage, force is the pressure we apply to the client's tissues. Pressure, on the other hand, is force distributed over an area. Understanding the difference is vital. Applying too much force over a small area can cause pain and tissue damage, while distributing the force over a larger area can provide a more comfortable and effective treatment. This brings us to the importance of how we apply that force. We need to think about the vectors of force, the direction in which we're applying pressure, and how that interacts with the tissues. For example, perpendicular pressure is more effective for deep tissue work, where shearing force can be useful for releasing facial restrictions. It's not just about how much pressure you use, but where it's going and how it's been received by the body. Of course, you can learn more about massage therapy in my books on Amazon, where you will find me as Eleftheria Mandzorou. We also need to consider the client's tissue density. A client with very dense muscularity will require more force to achieve a therapeutic effect than someone with softer tissues. But that doesn't mean you should push harder with your arms. Instead, this is where gravity comes in. It's your best friend as a therapist. It's free, it's always available, and when used properly, it can do much of the work for you. We must always be mindful of the client's feedback and adjust our pressure accordingly. Leverage is another key principle. It refers to the mechanical advantage gained by using a lever, a rigid bar that pivots on a fulcrum. In massage, our bodies are the levers, and our joints act as fulcrums. When I learned to use my body weight properly, everything changed. I no longer needed to use my upper body strength alone. By understanding leverage, we can minimize the effort required to apply force and reduce the risk of injury. Using our body weight, not our arm muscles, lets us apply greater pressure with less effort. Again, gravity helps us here. We should always strive to use our core muscles for stability and power, and avoid relying solely on our smaller, weaker muscles. This not only helps deliver more effective treatment, it also helps preserve our own bodies for the long haul. Even the height of the massage table is critical. It should allow us to work with our arms at a comfortable angle, minimizing strain on our shoulders and back. Using tools like bolsters and pillows can also help improve our body mechanics by supporting the client's body and allowing us to maintain a neutral spine. Again, all of this makes better use of gravity and better use of our structure. When we bring tools into the equation, like bamboo rollers or toxin tools, they change the biomechanics of the treatment. These tools can alter how force is delivered, what area is targeted, and how deep the pressure goes. They can be useful adjuncts to manual massage, but like everything else, they need to be used with an understanding of biomechanics. Without that, they can just as easily cause harm. By applying these biomechanical principles, we can optimize our massage techniques and prevent injury, For example, when performing deep tissue massage, we can use our body weight and leverage to apply sustained pressure without straining our wrists or arms. When performing myofascial release, we can use our body to create a gentle, sustained stretch, focusing on the direction of force and the client's tissue response. We should also be mindful of our own body's limitations and take regular breaks to prevent overuse injuries. This includes regular stretching and strengthening exercises to improve flexibility and stability, reducing the risk of chronic strain or injury over time. Remember, we are part of the therapeutic equation too. Research in this area is still evolving, but studies have shown that proper body mechanics and the use of ergonomic tools can significantly reduce the risk of musculoskeletal disorders in massage therapists. Future research should focus on developing standardized protocols for biomechanical assessment and intervention in massage therapy. We need to look at force plate analysis and motion capture to gain a more detailed picture of what is happening during a massage session, something that will help both therapists and clients in the long run. Hey, thank you for joining me today. I hope this episode has helped you understand the importance of biomechanics in massage and how working intelligently with your body, not against it, will always serve you better in the long term. Hey, and don't forget, gravity is always there to help. Use it.